We just covered the UK situation, where UK pretty much pressured Apple to remove their end-to-end encrypted feature, advanced data protection, and iCloud, which is a huge attack on encryption, not just for Apple, but potentially so many other services out there. Just today, at the time of recording, the FBI has warned iPhone and Android users that we want lawful access to all of your encrypted data. So this is not just a UK issue. We've seen it happen in Australia. We've seen it happen in many other countries around the world. So let's roll our own crypto. So you take control of your own data. We're going to use something called Cryptomator, which makes it super easy. It's open source, it's been audited, and it's pretty much compatible with any cloud provider. I will show you how this works very shortly, and I'll demo it for you. I already set up a couple VMs to go ahead and showcase how this works. So a couple prerequisites before we get started. One, you need a device that supports Cryptomator, which is pretty much available in every operating system, so that shouldn't be too hard. And the second thing you need is a cloud provider. It really doesn't matter, because the concept is you're encrypting these files before they touch the cloud. So I will be using Dropbox for this, because Dropbox is fairly cross-compatible across most operating systems, like macOS, Windows, and Linux. But you can use Google Drive, especially in the context of the UK with Apple. This does work with iCloud. So let's go ahead and dive into it. So the installation process for Cryptomator is different on every operating system, but their site is extremely well detailed, and it's pretty similar to installing any other software on your computer. So I'm going to skip forward to you already have Cryptomator installed. I also have here Dropbox, which is installed. So we now have a cloud provider as well as Cryptomator. Those are the two things you need to use Cryptomator. You can use Cryptomator with multiple cloud providers, but I'm just gonna demo one. So over here in the Dropbox folder, you're going to see there's a file here, and I just dragged this directly into the Dropbox. So this is just the HTML of our website, techlore.tech. That's just in there. If I log in online, it's gonna show me that. Again, Dropbox does not have end-to-end encryption, which means that Dropbox can read and access all of your data, but it's not just Dropbox, it's any hackers that get access into a Dropbox database. Hopefully that never happens, but if it does, then they get access to your data. It also means any governments that want access to your data through Dropbox can demand it from Dropbox. End-to-end encryption guarantees that your data stays with you, even if it's on someone else's server. So what we're gonna start with is you're going to go into Cryptomator, and the way Cryptomator works is through something called a vault. So your vault is like an encrypted flash drive or an encrypted area where everything is going to live in. So we're gonna start by just clicking plus, and we're gonna name this Henry's test, well, we can't use an apostrophe, Henry test vault. And you can see it automatically recognized Dropbox because I have it installed on my system. But I just want to demonstrate. So you can choose a custom location. And this is when I said you can use this with iCloud Drive. You can have 8 different cloud providers here. And if it doesn't automatically recognize one, you just select your cloud provider. You can use this with anything else, but you'll see how this works soon. So I'm just going to select Dropbox, click Next, and then Next. And now you're gonna set a password. So this is the password that's going to be required to unlock the vault. Remember, we're doing the encryption on your computer. So you're setting the password now, it's going to encrypt your items inside the vault, and then it's going to upload the entire vault, the encrypted vault with a password, into the cloud provider. So all Dropbox is gonna see is mumbo jumbo because it's an encrypted vault. Now on your other machine, you're going to need this password again. So this is going to be your universal password to access any files that you store inside this vault. So I'm just gonna do Henry here, keep this really simple. They make me do 8 characters. So Henry, Henry, super secure. Henry Henry. Storing sensitive documents, I do recommend setting up a recovery key. So I will encourage you all to do that. So here is my recovery key. Now I do recommend keeping this recovery key somewhere away from the device where you're setting this up. You can write this down on a piece of paper, you can store it in your password manager, or you can save it somewhere like a flash drive, or if you have like a NAS or something that's self-hosted, you can also keep it there. Just try to keep it somewhere that's away from your main system. So if you lose access to the password, you can still get in. You're gonna click Next, and then you're just gonna say unlock now. So as you can see, there's now a vault, Henry test vault, and then there's password Henry Henry, unlock. Unlock successful, and I'm getting all these prompts because it's the first time I'm setting this up, but then you can just reveal the drive. And here it is. Here's a little thing that Cryptomator shows by default. Any files added to this volume would be encrypted by Cryptomator. Feel free to remove this file. So I go ahead and delete this when I do this because it's good for beginners, but we are watching this guide, so you don't need that. Now, on our website, techlore.tech, you can go to our Go Incognito course. You can watch it for free, or there's the premium version too, but let's say you want to download the logo. This is going to be our logo that we're going to use, and we're going to try to unlock this on a different device. So we're going to go here and drag this in. So now a couple things before I lock this out. Cryptomator is extremely simple to use, so there aren't that many settings. So you can go ahead and just reveal drive if you ever want to access this in a very convenient way, and it'll show you all your encrypted things. Now I'm actually going to drag this twice in there because I want to demonstrate that a vault is almost like a folder. This is like a big bucket that's going to store everything inside of it. Please do not use Cryptomator in a way where you create a vault for every file, so you just have an infinite number of vaults each for one file. That's not really how you should be using Cryptomator. So ideally what you do is you do like Henry Test Vault. You can do work, and then you're going to do a work one, and then you're also going to have maybe a backup one for your important backups for your documents. And then maybe you have one for your family, so you can also share a vault with your family. But my point is, you should have vaults, but they're used as buckets or folders that store many other files in them. Again, more than one file. You can just keep one file, but that's pretty impractical. When you're done with this, you just click lock, and then it's going to shut down, as you saw the finder in the background, and you're just left with this. And now, what's going to happen here? If you pull up Dropbox, you're going to see all this random crap. This is, I don't know what this is, actually. And the great part is neither does Dropbox. No one actually knows what this is. If you pull up Dropbox, you're going to see a folder here, which is Henry Test Vault. And this, again, is like a folder or a vault. And then if you go ahead and open this up, you're going to see these different things here. But if you try to open any of it, important.rtf, this is your vault storage location. All this tells you is that you used Cryptomator, but you can't actually open any of these files. If you try to open the vault.cryptomator, it's just going to open Cryptomator and you have to unlock it. This is really important to understand because it means that Dropbox cannot access your data because, again, you're encrypting it locally on your machine. Now, before I pivot over to my second operating system to show how to sync these files on a new operating system, let me just show you preferences real quick. So you can launch Cryptomator on system start, which is good if you're hoping to use Cryptomator on a daily basis, so it's just always running. You can hide window when you start Cryptomator, and you can lock open vaults automatically when you quit the application. So if you have an open vault and you quit the app or you shut things down, it will lock it automatically, which I actually think is a very good feature and I like to enable. You can store passwords in macOS keychain, or depending on the operating system, you're going to see some different stuff here. For most people, you should probably leave this on by default, but some people who are more advanced might want to go ahead and tinker with that if they prefer their passwords to be stored in some other capacity. In terms of the interface, there's the system default. You can unlock a dark mode, but that is behind a paywall. Again, Cryptomator is free to use, so anyone who can support it definitely should support it. It's a great piece of software. They do have a tray icon, so you see up here, this would be the tray icon. You can enable a compact vault list. So if you're someone that has a lot of vaults, you'll see how this got small. And then also I do recommend enabling check for updates automatically, which is something I think everyone should do on all their software. The last few settings are in the vault. So you click the vault and you click vault options and you can rename your vault. You can lock it when idle. So if you don't touch your computer for like 5 minutes, it will automatically lock. I do recommend having at least a max. The max can vary depending on what you need, but I think having something like 60 minutes is good if you're someone who has a habit of just leaving your computer unlocked. But of course, if you have something like a desktop and it's sitting on your desk all the time, it might be inconvenient after a while to have to constantly unlock your vault. Really depends on how sensitive what you're working on tends to be. You can be prompted to unlock the vault when you start Cryptomator. And then after a successful unlock, you can go ahead and customize what happens. Like you can automatically reveal the drive, which I think is by far the best behavior, but I know some people might not prefer that. You can start a health check where it will see if the drives are fully synced and if there is no data corruption. So I'm going to go ahead and just do a sample of what that looks like. And then you can select all checks and then run a check. Luckily, there's not many files, so there's not much to check and everything looks good, but this is a way to confirm that everything is legitimately secure and still there. In terms of mounting, you can mount your drive in other areas, this is quite a bit more advanced. But if you're someone who likes to self-host things or do really fun stuff, you can actually mount these in totally different areas, which opens up some really cool opportunities for people who know what they're doing. And finally, you can change your password and you can display your recovery key with your password. So these are varying things that you can customize within Cryptomator. Now, the moment you've all been waiting for, let's go ahead and move over to a different operating system and actually try to sync this and see how it works. So I had to install a third-party Dropbox client, but it shouldn't really change anything just because there's nothing supported on ARM from Dropbox themselves. So you're going to see here open Dropbox folder, and I just logged in for the first time on the system, and you're going to see Henry test vault here. Now, if I open the Henry test vault, once again, you're just going to see mumbo jumbo. You can open this folder and it's literally mumbo jumbo. Remember, we only uploaded two files, the two SVG files, but you're not able to access those and there's no way to really view those. Now, I went ahead and just opened Cryptomator. Again, the only two things you need to do any of this on any operating system is a way to sync your files, like a cloud provider or Cryptomator. So here I have my vault on the left that's syncing through Dropbox. It doesn't look like Dropbox, but I promise you it's Dropbox. And then here on Cryptomator, I'm going to click a vault. And then instead of saying create new vault, you're going to open existing vault. You're going to choose your folder. I'm going to go to home. And this is my Dropbox right here. And I'm going to open and you're going to see Henry test vault. And you're going to select vault.cryptomator. Open, added vault, and then you're just going to do unlock now. Remember the password? I remember the password. Henry Henry. Unlock successful, and then reveal drive. And now, instead of the mumbo jumbo, we have our two files. And just like that, we just made Dropbox end-to-end encrypted. Pretty cool. Now, you can do this with iCloud, you can do this with Google Drive, you can do this with your NAS, you can do this with Nextcloud, you can do this with quite literally anything. Now, before we finish up, a few very important things you need to know. Please do not move away from the video before you have these things down. One, if you want to maximize security of Cryptomator, make sure you're using a much stronger password than just Henry Henry. I recommend generating something in your password manager or ideally using something like a passphrase so that you can save it elsewhere. And then you can use that in conjunction with storing your recovery key in a safe place. So please layer up your backup methods so that you have access to your data, because even worse than Apple ADP, if you lose access to your recovery key, Apple still can't help you. But Cryptomator, they are not gonna help you. There is somewhat of an organization behind it, but they're not gonna have 24/7 support trying to help you to recover your data. This is your encryption. So if you lose your keys, you lose your data. Some downsides also to Cryptomator you should be aware of. Performance is always going to be a little bit slower, right? Like, it's encrypting things, it's one extra thing you need to do, so it's not ever going to be quite as smooth or quite as fast as just uploading to something without end-to-end encryption. Reliability is another problem that a lot of people have had, including myself, especially when you have larger files and versioning and things get really complex. Cryptomator can fail sometimes, so I do recommend doing health checks in your vault pretty frequently to make sure nothing goes wrong, and always store backups. I have seen horror stories with Cryptomator where people lose some data and they don't get it back, so I don't want to say that Cryptomator isn't reliable enough for most people, because it definitely is. It's very good, very solid, and I really enjoy it. But just like any sort of storage, especially in the cloud, please have backups. Another downside with Cryptomator is it won't integrate with third parties quite as well. When you're using Dropbox, you might be able to have a third-party service get access to your data in Dropbox. So it's really more of like anyone can integrate well, but that's just not really an option with Cryptomator. With Cryptomator, no one can access your data except what happens locally on your machine. So just be aware of that. And because of all of these limitations, Cryptomator, unless you go with the business plan, isn't probably the best for teams. So if you have four people all editing a document at the same time, that's really pushing it, I think, for the capabilities of Cryptomator. Though it's something that's worth trying if you want to test it out and see how well it works for you. Now, you might hear these limitations and go, oof, I don't know if I can actually use Cryptomator, but let me challenge you on one thing. This is not all or nothing. If you actually go here and go into your Dropbox, you'll see that there's still that unencrypted file, and then there's the encrypted vault. So you could have all of your data pretty much unencrypted on Dropbox, but then there's a few sensitive documents that you want end-to-end encrypted, and then create a vault for those. So this is not all or nothing. You can still use iCloud, mostly not end-to-end encrypted, but then for the things that you really care about, put it in a vault. Did you get value from this? If you did, give it a like, subscribe, and share it with someone you know. I wanted this to be accessible to anyone, regardless of how young, old, experienced, inexperienced they are. So definitely let me know below if this helped you out. If you really enjoyed it, definitely check us out on Patreon at patreon.com/techlore. That's how we can do free stuff like this. And we also can't do it without some of our sponsors like NoteSnook. So thank you, NoteSnook. Thank you to our supporters. And also go ahead and check out the video on the screen right now for how to be private on a budget, which features tools like Cryptomator, which are free to start using. See you next time on TechLore.